Member for Victoria Beacon Hill.
Thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. I'm pleased to rise and speak to the member's motion that talks about fiscal management and creating opportunities for British Columbians. And I'm not sure what part of the province the member is spending time in, because he's certainly not, when he talks about citizens being further ahead, certainly not talking to the British Columbians that I talk to and that others talk to every single day, who in fact are struggling to get by, who are having a difficult time managing paycheck to paycheck. For the member to say that the government is creating opportunities for British Columbians, I wish, Honourable Speaker, I wish this was a budget that actually spoke to creating opportunities for British Columbians. I wish that we had a chance for every British Columbian to benefit from British Columbia's economy. But that doesn't happen under this government, Honourable Speaker. Just the opposite, in fact. And I want to use a couple of very specific examples. The first one, Honourable Speaker, being cuts to education. Education in the broad sense. What could be more important in creating opportunity for people in this province than education? It is, in fact, the foundation of opportunity. So we start off with the kindergarten to grade 12 system that the government in this budget hasn't even put enough money in to manage the downloading of costs and the increase enrollment, which means once again we're going to see cuts to education. The government also says to school boards, we think you have a lot of extra money lying around, so we're going to actually ask you to hand back some of the money that we give to you. Well, that's the complete opposite of providing opportunity, Honourable Speaker. What about adult basic education? People who've been in the workforce who decide that they want to go back and better themselves. They want to get a job where they can earn more money to support their family. They're doing everything right. They decide they're going to take that upgrading of grade 12 math that they didn't need to graduate when they graduated, but now they need to get into an apprenticeship program, for example. What does this government do? The government decides they'll charge them for it. That used to be free. They were able to do that because we recognize how important it is to give people a hand up. Not a hand out, a hand up. And yet this government decides, no, we're going to start charging for adult basic education upgrading. And by the way, while we do that, we're also going to start charging for ESL business courses. So again, for people who want to learn the language of business when it comes to English as a second language, they now have to pay as well. So again, closing the door to opportunity is what this government is doing. Again, post-secondary education. We see them 3 years in a row, they've actually asked post-secondary education again to give back money to the government instead of recognizing the investment that that is in all of our future. Investing in education is a smart investment, Honourable Speaker. It provides opportunity for people. Now let's take a look at hardworking British Columbians. I heard the members say that citizens are further ahead. Well, not when they take a look at the fees and services this government has added on to them. 77% increase in ferry fares, a 48% increase in ICBC rates, 108% increase in medical service premiums, 74% increase in hydro rates. You name it, this government has nickeled and dimed families since they've come into play. And for families, that doesn't make it easier to get ahead. There is not a surprise, Honourable Speaker, when you take a look at the increase in the use of payday loans in British Columbia, when you take a look at the statistics that show we have the highest per capita debt in British Columbia. That's because families aren't getting by. That's because families are struggling. And I haven't even talked about the outrageous decision by government to say to people on disabilities, by the way, we're giving you some money for disabilities every month, but we're taking your bus pass back. So now you'll have to pay for that. So never mind that we've given you a little tiny bit. We're actually going to remove that money from you and take it back. That isn't providing people with opportunity, Honourable Speaker. That's doing just the opposite. Diversification of the economy, well, I'm glad the government finally learned the word diversification after we've seen a premier who has done nothing but talk about LNG and drive LNG and forget about all the other industries that thankfully, despite the government, are continuing on, like tourism, like high tech, like arts and culture, like forestry. barely hanging on, not able to get attention from this government, not able to see the kind of time and support that they deserve because this premier decided that LNG with blinders on was the only thing that she was going to pay attention to. So, Honourable Speaker, I am a proud British Columbian. I want our economy to do well. I want the people of our province to do well. But that's not what we saw in the budget that came forward. Thank you, Honourable Speaker.
Thank you, Member.